Good morning, good morning. Good morning. When you come in, please share. I appreciate it. Come on in. You can hear the music. If you can give me a thumbs up or tell me you can hear it, I appreciate it. Good morning, good morning. Come on in. We'll get started in a few minutes. Waiting for a few more people to join in. Charvay, if you can hear the music, let me know. I appreciate it. Come on in. If you come in, you can hit that like and share button. I greatly appreciate it. Great. Thank you so much. Invite your followers, please. Invite those on your timeline, your news feed. We'll get started in a few minutes. Good morning. Good morning. I knew a few more people were going to join, so I said, let me hold on for a little bit. Good morning. Good morning. I'm sure y'all never heard of this music in the background. Good morning. Come on in. As you come in, if you can hit that share button, I appreciate it. Y'all want that again?
This is an app for project management.
That's one thing about YouTube. If you don't have the other stuff, it's going to create an issue. That's not it either. There it is. All right. We'll get started in about 30 seconds. Just waiting for a few more people to join. Good morning. Y'all don't know nothing about this song. Nothing at all. If you know about this song, give me thumbs up or give me some hearts. Good morning, good morning. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Let me good stuff. All right. There we go. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I pray that you're well, that you have having a good morning so far. I am Reverend Kevin V. Montague, founder of KVM Ministries. And welcome to Jumpstart Encouragement and Prayer Broadcast, coming to you live on Facebook as well as on Periscope. Jumpstart is a Friday morning encouragement and prayer broadcast. The goal of this broadcast is to jumpstart your day. Boom! Hopefully your day is jumpstarted just like that, so that you're able to live your life better, so that you're able to see further what God has for you and to achieve greater. In other words, achieve all that God has for you as you walk out the rest of your life on purpose. Amen. Thank you so much for joining on Facebook Live as well as on Periscope and supporting KVM Ministries LLC. Once again, hit that share button and like button and share, because you never know who may need this word, all because, and they will thank you for sharing this broadcast with them. Amen. All right. So we are now talking about, this is part two of the patience principles, part two, the patience principles. So if there was a part two, there had to be a part one. So last week, we had part one, and I talked about how at times I can be a perfectionist. Yes, I struggle in that area often, especially when it comes to traffic. Anybody was in traffic last week during the Memorial Day weekend? I struggle with patience, even dealing with family and friends and even my children. Oh, goodness. I struggle at times in my patience, and especially at work. When you're waiting on an assignment and you can already go home, and next thing you know, you have to wait for somebody to give you something so you can complete your portion. Yeah, it's a struggle. It really is a huge struggle. So let me ask you a question. What areas in your life you need to exercise a little bit more patience? Is it with your spouse? Is it with your financial state? What's going on in your life? You know, Rome wasn't built in a day, and some turnarounds in your life isn't going to happen just overnight. So type on the screen real quick. I want this interaction in a little bit. What area in your life do you need to exercise patience in? I'll give you a few seconds. Type on the screen, because someone else may be struggling through this as well. What area in your life? Okay. That means moving your fingers. Yes. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. And I know for myself, even somebody say home and at work. What else? What else we have? Even at restaurants, you know how that goes. When you go to a restaurant and you know, you get there and you're sitting there and another group comes in and they get their order before you. Yeah, that's not, you know, life itself. Yeah. You need to, yeah, that's important. And I know for me, especially at restaurants, you're waiting on the waitress or the waiter, and you're saying, okay, it's only been 15, 20 minutes, and I still don't have my drink of water, and I don't have my utensils. I don't have a fork or a spoon. I don't have a napkin. Or I don't have my appetizers, especially at restaurants. We can really get impatient. Amen? So patience is the ability to accept delay, endure long suffering, or without complaining or becoming angry. It's the ability to wait or to continue doing something despite difficulties, or to suffer without complaining or becoming annoyed. Without becoming annoyed. We are so easily annoyed by life, by people, by situations. And patience is often hard to gain and harder to maintain. This is my recap of patience, the patience principle, part one. But in Romans 15, 5, it says this: God is the God of patience, God of patience or steadfastness. And I'm so grateful that we're able to go to God and to rely on God and to accept his will, so that we can trust in his goodness, trust in his wisdom, trust in his faithfulness, that he will enable us to endure, to be able to be steadfast, and to be patient and wait on him, because he has it all under control. Yes, he does. He has it all under control. Patience reveals our faith in God's timing, his omnipotence, and love. It also reveals our submission and surrounding to God's plan, even though we don't see what he's doing behind the scene and have given up on our own control of the situation, knowing God is working it out for our good. Amen. And we talked about last week, we need to be patient in three areas. Patience with ourselves. Yeah, God is maturing you. Patience with people. Oh, God. We have to, you know, yeah, people. Yeah. Humility becomes part of our need, because we have to think about it. We were probably in their shoes as well, and someone waited patiently on us. So we have to be patient with people. Yeah, I understand. They're taking their time, but someone took their time for us. Amen. Can I get some hearts on that? Someone was patient with us. Someone cared enough to take their time with us and wait on us so that we can get some act right. Amen. The next thing is patient with God. The Lord is never late, but delayed on purpose. He doesn't operate in our timing. So we have to be patient even with God. And we patient with God, we know that he is bringing us out and bringing us through a situation in order to give himself glory. It's not about you, but it's all about God. So I prayed this last week saying, dear God, create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew a steadfast or patient spirit within me. That was Psalms 51:10. So we're going to go ahead and conclude this two-part series with the patient principles part two. Patient principles part two. I'm going to start off with a story. You ready? Here we go. One telephone operator turned to another and said, he's a patient man. I was flustered and gave, wait a minute, let me go back. One telephone operator turned to another and said, he's a patient man. I was flustered and gave him a wrong number four times. He said so kindly. So you gave me the wrong number four times, operator? Try once again. I'd like to meet this man. And the other inquired, what is his number? When she was told, she said, I know him. He's my pastor. Then said the other, I'm going to hear him preach. Amen. That means his witness was strong enough to get somebody else to move, to want to know more about what is it that's causing him or has him in a comfortable position to be able to be patient, even when he didn't have to be patient. Amen. It is said that patience is a virtue, meaning the ability to wait for something without getting angry or upset is a valuable quality in a person. Do we have that valuable quality in us? Patience is part of the fruit of the Spirit. God is patient, and his Spirit produces the fruit of patience in us. When we are patient, we leave room for God to work in our hearts and to work in our relationships. We lay down our schedule and trust in his will. We thank the Lord for what he's doing, what he's brought us out of, and what he's bringing us to. And then we let God be God. Patience comes from a position of power. In other words, losing patience is a sign of weakness. Did you know that? Losing patience is a sign of weakness, but patience comes from a position of power and control. Patience should be daily and an intentional action. Colossians 3:12 says this, since God chose you to be holy people, he loves you. You must clothe yourself. In other words, put some clothes on. Clothe yourself with tenderhearted mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and here goes that word again, and patience. That's right. Daily, as we put on our clothes, we put on our shorts, we put on our shirt, we put on our garments, whatever it is. We do that daily, right? Daily, we need to put on patience. Put on some patience today. So I'm going to give you 5 patient principles that will help your life out. All right, you ready? Here we go. Patience number one. Patient principle number one. Patience keeps your witness and is seen by others. Amen? Patience keeps your witness and is seen by others. Scripture says this, hot tempers causes arguments, but patience brings peace. Peace. Patience brings peace. Patience keeps your witness, especially with those who are not believers, because they always looking for us to fall, or they always looking for us to mess up, because, you know, you save, sanctify. So, you know, you should always be patient. That's true. Sometimes we struggle and we fall, but patience should help us keep our witness, and it should be seen by others as beneficial. Amen? That's number one. Number two, patience builds our character to be productive and useful. Patience builds our character to be productive and useful. Scripture says this, in view of all of this, make every effort to respond to God's promises. Supplement your faith with a generous provision of moral excellence, and more excellence with knowledge. In other words, he's building now. More excellence with knowledge, and knowledge with self-control. So we're putting all these old things on here, on us, so that we can be better, so that we can be more productive and useful. Then it says, and self-control with patience, patient endurance, and patient endurance with godliness. And godliness with brotherly affection, and brotherly affection with love for everyone. In other words, patience has to be in the midst of your growth process. You can't grow without having this element of patience. Verse 8 says this, the more you grow like this, the more you have patience and all these other things, the more productive and useful you will be in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. So if you want to grow, if you want to mature, if you want to grow up in the faith, you got to have a little bit more patience. So patience to keep your witness and seen by others. Patience builds our character to be productive and useful. The third one is patience shows the depth of our love. Yes, the depth. How much do you love a person will be shown through how patient you are with somebody. Come on, somebody. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Patience shows the depth of your love. It says this, love is patient. So if there's no love, guess what? There won't be any patience. So patience shows the depth of your love. It says this, be always humble and gentle and patient. Let me go back to that again. Be always humble, gentle. And then lastly, it says, patient. Then it says this, show your love by being tolerant or patient with one another. Do your best to preserve the unity which the Spirit gives by means of the peace that binds you together. So patience is important to show the depth of your love, and also, once again, to keep the peace and unity that you have in relationship with other people. Oftentimes our relationship struggles because we aren't patient with one another. Patience shows your love. And if you can display your love to somebody through patience, guess what you will receive in return? Patience. Patience. You will receive the love of God through someone else being patient with you. I just thank God that he was patient with me every day. Because I don't get it right every day. I'm not patient. But he says, I love you this much to wait for you to get some act right together. Amen? Here we go. The next one is, patience can save us. Here we go. It says this, I waited patiently for the Lord to help me, and he turned to me and heard my cry. Good morning, Yasmin. I waited patiently for the Lord to help me, and he turned to me and heard my cry. He lifted me out of my despair. Wait a minute, let me go back. It says, I waited patiently for the Lord. And this is what he did. He turned to me and heard my cry. He lifted me up out of the pit of despair, out of the mud, out of the mire, out of the mess, out of the sin, out of the brokenness of my situation. He set my feet on solid ground and steadied me as I walked along. He has given me a new song to sing, a hymn of praise to our God. Many will see what he's done and be amazed. They will put their trust in the Lord. He was patient with all of us. All of us need God to be patient with us. And you know what? I'm so thankful that he even hears our cry, even when we are going through a situation where we don't really understand how to be patient, but he hears us, he helps us, he picks us up, he turns us around, and he gives us a firm foundation. Amen? Amen. It says, the Lord is good to everyone who trusts in him. So it is best, it says this, so it is best for us to wait in patience, to wait for him to save us, and it's best to learn this patience in our youth. Imagine if we learn how to be patient while we were young. How many things have we put ourselves in a bad situation as we got older and wish, if I learned how to handle this situation properly when I was young, woo! Let me tell you, I would not be in a financial situation I was in. I would not have been in the relationship situations I was in. I would have been a lot further along, closer to my purpose, if I was able to wait and be patient and trust in him. Amen. The last thing, patience is rewarded by God. That's right. There's a reward when we are patient with God. Amen. It says this, but those who wait for the Lord, in other words, those who patiently expect and wait and look for and put their hope in him, will gain new strength and renew their power. They will lift up their wings and rise up close to God like eagles rising toward the sun. They will run and not become weary. They will walk and not grow tired. So God will reward you as you are patient. You will gain new strength. You will gain new power. God will give you wings and allow you to rise up and rise above your situation, rise above your clouds. In other words, to give you a better view of what he's actually already doing for you so that you can have a brighter day, a brighter moment, a brighter expectation of what he's doing to bring you out and cause great blessings in your life. Amen. So just to encourage you, it says this, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a huge crowd of witnesses to the life of faith, let us strip off every weight that slows us down. You know, like in a when you are running a marathon, it's not a quick thing. It takes time. It takes patience. It takes knowledge and ability. And also it takes skill to know when to actually run fast. It says this, especially the sin that so easily trips us up. Yes, the sin that so easily trips us up could be impatience. It trips us up when we go too fast, when we don't pace ourselves. And it says this, and let us run with endurance the race that God has set before us. Let us be patient today. Let us be patient so that we're able to keep our witness and be seen by others. Let us be patient so we're able to have our character built up and be more productive and useful for the kingdom. Let us be more patient so that we can show the love of God for those that we really don't like. Yeah, that's the hardest thing is to be able to show patience and love to someone that even has hurt us. Oh, I'm talking really good right now. To be able to be patient when someone has cut us off, like in traffic, or to be patient even when someone cussed us out, but we are still able to show how much we love them in our patience. The next thing, patience can save us. Boy, I wish I would learn that when I was young, how to be patient in everything. And last thing, patience is a reward by God. So I pray today that you exercise some patience, that you will take these patience principles with you throughout the day so that you are able to be a greater witness and reflect the love of God, because he loved you that much and waited for you so we can share the love of God through our patience with our brothers and sisters, those that are believers and especially those who do not know who Christ is, because through your patience, they may want to know, what must I do to be saved? Who is this person that this person who once was off the chain now is patiently in control and waiting for God? Who is this God? I want to know who they are. Amen? Amen. Let's pray. Father, we graciously thank you, God, for this day. You are a wonderful and perfect God. We thank you for our rising up and waking us up. Father, for this is the day that you have made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Father, I ask right now, God, that you keep us, that you mold us, that you give us your love so that we can be patient with one another. You saved us to be patient. You healed us so that we're able to be patient even with those that are struggling through their issues. Father, allow us to be a witness. Allow us to reflect on your love and what you've done for us. You didn't have to do it. You didn't have to be patient and die on the cross for us, but you did. And I'm so grateful, God, that you saw it fit to love us enough to see a sinful wreck like us, a hot mess, to save us so that we can operate by faith and not by sight. Give us the endurance. Give us the knowledge. Give us the more excellence. Give us the godliness. But most of all, give us the patience so that we can be more productive and be more like you. This is our prayer. In Jesus Christ's name, we do pray. Amen. Amen. I got a hot song real quick. I'm going to play it real quick. As soon as I can get this thing up and running, I'm going to play it. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Y'all probably never heard this song before. It's coming. It's coming. All right. It's coming. Come on, song. Come on. Come on. Y'all heard this song before? Give me some thumbs up. Give me some hearts.
Listen. I know you have questions, same ones as me. How long has it been? How long will it be? When will come the morning? Drive the night away. Tell me when will come the morning of a brighter day? Yeah, oh, patience.
Who can name that movie?
Little sister, patience. Little brother, patience, patience. Yeah. Take each other by the hand. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, patience.
All right. Y'all don't know that song? That was in the Dreamgirls soundtrack, and it's called Patience. And one of the stars that actually singing on this is Eddie Murphy. Amen. I think Eddie's going to come up. Come on, Eddie. Come on in. There's Eddie. Eddie Murphy. Eddie Murphy. All right, y'all. Real quick, thank you again for joining the Jumpstart Encouragement and Prayer Broadcast, where the goal of this broadcast is to jumpstart your day so you're able to live better, see further, and achieve greater. Don't forget to like my page and also go to my Facebook page and my Instagram and Twitter, and also to my website, kvmministriesllc.wixsite.com, and follow me there. Good stuff there. All the videos are there as well. Lastly, I want to invite you to join me on this Sunday at my church, the Providence St. John Baptist Church, 5607 Old Crane Highway in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. The pastor is Billy T. Staten Jr., an awesome man of God. And this weekend is Youth Takeover Weekend, where the youth take over everything, or the whole service. But it starts on tomorrow, where they have a big game and fun festivities at the church, and it's free. Come on out, be a part of this, but also join us for Sunday service, 7:30 a.m. service, as well as 10:45 a.m. 7:45 a.m. and 10:30 a.m. service. Come on out. You get a good worship, good word, good fellowship, and good family. God bless you all. Y'all have a wonderful day. Be encouraged. Patience. Patience. Be a little more patient because someone was patient with you. Amen. God bless you all. Peace. Yeah.